Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Inshallah, we will continue the series regarding the virtues, the importance, and the essentials of the day of Jum'ah. Last week or last time, we went over the first khutbah and the first sermon of a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he ever offered. Today, inshallah, we will discuss upon whom Salatul Jum'ah is compulsory and an obligation, and then this week we will go over the punishment or the consequence for those people who do not attend or offer Salatul Jum'ah. And inshallah, the next week we will go over the virtues of performing Salatul Jum'ah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith that al-jum'atu haqqun wajibun ala kulli muslim. That Jum'ah is wajib upon every Muslim fi jama'atin, in congregation, except for four types of people. Number one, abdun mamlukun, a slave. Number two, amimra'a, a woman. O sabiyun, a child, and he was not an adult yet. And o maridun, and a sick person, a deceased person who is bedridden and cannot travel or cannot go out of his home. Upon these people, yani Salatul Jum'ah will be wajib upon them as long as they fulfill four conditions. Number one, men, yani Salatul Jum'ah is wajib upon men. Number two, they are free, yani they're not slaves. Number three, they are adults. And number four, they are in good health. Salatul Jum'ah will not be compulsory upon a disabled person who is unable to go to the masjid. Or going for Jum'ah will increase their sickness. Our Ustad and our Shaykh, who is also the Musannif and the author of this book, he used to say, how do you know if you are in good shape or in good health to make sure that you can attend the masjid or not? If there is any other place that you can go to, you can go to work, you can go to the grocery store, if you can go anywhere else, then you have the physical capability and the health to attend Salatul Jum'ah. If you can't go anywhere else, and you cannot leave your home, then you do not have to perform Salatul Jum'ah, and inshallah there will be no punishment for that person. I'm going to go over a few narrations that he wrote in this book called The Essentials of Jum'ah. The PDF is available, and it will be on our website too if anyone wants to see it, inshallah. So he compiled a few narrations about the severe warning against missing Salat al-Jum'ah. The first hadith is by Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma and Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu. Annahu samia Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul. They heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, people must stop missing Salat al-Jum'ah, otherwise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will seal their hearts, then they will become amongst the ignorant. Any performing and attending Salat al-Jum'ah is a means and a protection for someone, you know, being protected from being ignorant. In another narration, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man taraka al-jum'ata thalasa marratan," whoever leaves Salatul Jum'ah, yani does not attend Salatul Jum'ah, three consecutive Salatul Jum'ah that he misses, then the Prophet, and without a valid reason, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will seal their hearts. You can see the importance the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave for Salatul Jum'ah. Throughout the week, we've been discussing the importance of performing salah in congregation and the importance of performing salah in congregation and how the Prophet ﷺ had a desire to tell the ummah to try to perform all of your salawat in congregation. So many narrations that, but if you look at Salatul Jum'ah, the Prophet ﷺ gave it a different types of importance for attending Salatul Jum'ah. If you miss three Salatul Jum'ahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will seal your hearts. In other words, you won't be able to do good anymore. Why? Because you didn't attend Salatul Jum'ah. What was the Prophet ﷺ always worried about? He wasn't worried about himself more than he was worried about us. يَؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا. Over and over, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is looking for ways for this ummah to be united. And the day of Jum'ah, Salatul Jum'ah, was the day of congregation, was the day of gathering. And majority of the Muslims, if you didn't see them throughout the week, it was the day of Jum'ah that you met them. You're working throughout the week. You're working every day. The Prophet ﷺ made a day where we can all gather. We can all be together. The narration, in another narration, the Prophet ﷺ said, or the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'een said that after Salatul Jummah, we would eat our lunch and then we would perform Qaylulah. Yani after Salatul Jummah was a time we spent time together. So if you look at it just from the Salah perspective, the Prophet ﷺ is talking about severe warning against them. But then also the reason why, because it was a means of congregation. It was a means of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'een meeting each other. You know, when we're constantly on our work, we're constantly worried about work, we forget about each other. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted a day where the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een gathered to be together. Where the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'een made an effort to put aside all of the tasks that they were doing, all of the work that we're doing, just so they can gather together. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man taraka al-jum'ata thalathatan." Whoever misses Salat al-Jum'ah min ghayri udhrin, without a valid reason, فَهُوَ مُنَافِقٌ, then he's a hypocrite. I understand what we're dealing with is in this era, in this moment, with this pandemic. But with whatever effort we can, at least try to make sure you attend Salat al-Jum'ah. مَنْ تَرَكَ, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ تَرَكَ الْجُمْعَةَ ثَلَاثًا بِغَيْرِ عُذْرٍ فَهُوَ مُنَافِقٌ, then that person is a hypocrite. And another narration, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حَلَاكُ أُمَّتِي فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالْلَبَنِ. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, My ummah will be destroyed فِي الْكِتَابِ, in regarding the book, al-laban, milk. Messenger of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu ajma'in, they said, Ya Rasulullah, مَا الْكِتَابُ وَالْلَبَنِ. What do you mean by al-kitab and milk? What do you mean by the book and milk? What do you mean my ummah will be destroyed by that? The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَتَعَلَّمُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. People will learn Qur'an and they will incorrectly interpret it. They will give the incorrect tafsir. They will give the tafsir and the explanation of the Qur'an based off of their own understanding. يَتَعَلَّمُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. They'll learn Qur'an, but they'll give the wrong explanation for it. Ya Rasulullah, what do you mean by milk? The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that they would leave worshipping Allah due to their love for milk. What does it mean? What do you mean their love for milk? The Sahaba radiallahu ajma'in explained that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was explaining to us that milk was something indirectly meant for their love of this dunya. This world, their businesses, their jobs, their occupation, what they're occupied with, what they're busy with, will cause them to miss Salat al-Jum'ah. They will be so caught up in their work. Due to their love for milk, they will miss the Jum'ah and congregational prayer. And yani they will go wherever they can to get a job. Yani the purpose will not be to move and live somewhere to please Allah, to make sure that they can attend the masajid. But the purpose of why they migrated or why they moved somewhere will be because of their business. About 3 weeks ago, I met a brother who moved from Pakistan. He was offered a very good job. And he's been looking for a job for a very long time. But he said, I have one condition. I can't miss Salat al-Jum'ah. This brother still does not have a job. I think recently he's about to get a job. But the point is that Salat al-Jum'ah is the essence. Now, alhamdulillah, actually the brother does have a job. He was telling the story from before. But he was so firm, no matter what, I won't work full time, even though I have a degree in it. There's no way I'm missing Salat al-Jum'ah. There's still hope for this ummah if Salat al-Jum'ah is still given its due importance. There's very lengthy narration. I won't go over the whole narration. But the summary of it, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that people won't have a job. There will be people that won't have work to do. They won't be busy. And they will do the zikr of Allah. They'll do the ibadah of Allah. They'll attend all the prayers. They'll attend Salat al-Jum'ah. Then what will happen is that they get a job. Then they start missing some of the daily salawat. Maybe they're not coming for Fajr. Maybe they're not coming for Salat al-Ashr. Maybe they stop coming for Salat al-Maghrib. They stop coming for Salat al-Isha because now they have a job. Then what will happen? And the example that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave was people of farmers. That they will have cattle, they will have animals, they won't have that many, so they don't have too much of a headache. You know, the grass and the land that they have, it's enough to graze the animals. Then what will happen? They will get more cattle animals, they'll get more animals, now they need a bigger land. So they're going to move farther away from the masjid. Because they need more land in order to graze the cattle animals. Then what will happen? He will only attend Salatul Jum'ah. He will only be able to attend Salatul Jum'ah. Then he's getting more business. His business is increasing. He has an opportunity to make a lot more money. And now he misses Salatul Jum'ah without a valid reason. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whether in my life or after me, whether the leader of that time, meaning the Prophet ﷺ telling the Sahaba, whether the leader of that time is just or a tyrant, regardless of what position he's in, Allah will not serve or take care of any of his affairs, and that will not bless any of his work if he does not salah, accept 10 salah. And nothing will be accepted from him. His salah will not be accepted. His zakat will not be accepted. His hajj will not be accepted. His fasting will not be accepted. None of his good deeds will be accepted until he repents. And then if he repents, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his repentance. So missing Salatul Jum'ah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us severe and many warnings. In another narration, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, make sure that you frequent the masjid, and make sure that you attend Salatul Jum'ah, and try to sit as close to the Imam as you can, because a person is distanced from Jannah due to his absence from Salatul Jum'ah, though he was worthy of being from amongst the dwellers of Jannah. Again, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, make sure you're present for Salatul Jum'ah. Sit close to the Imam, because a person is distanced from Jannah due to his absence from Salatul Jum'ah, even though he is worthy of being from amongst the dwellers of Jannah. If space runs out, you can go to the old sister's side on the right side. There's more space on the right side. If brothers come afterwards, you can tell them that the door should be open. If there's any space, you can go there too. Another hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu was asked about a person who fasts all day and prays the whole night, but he does not attend Salatul Jum'ah or the congregational prayer. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu responded, huwa fi an-nar. He will be in the fire. Doesn't matter what else he's doing. But Salatul Jum'ah, or attending congregational prayer, was from amongst the teachings and the importance of the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We'll end with this last hadith. Jabir radiallahu ta'ala, he says that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawm al-akhir fa'alayhi al-jum'ah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever believes in Allah and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and believes in the last day, he should pray Salatul Jum'ah unless he is sick, he's a traveler, a woman, a child, or a slave. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be indifferent towards one who is indifferent towards Salatul Jum'ah due to his being preoccupied with his businesses or his entertainment, whatever he's doing. And Allah is independent and Allah is worthy of praise. If you look at it, Salatul Jum'ah should be the cause of building a community, should be the beginning cause of building a community. If a person is not doing anything, he's not able to come for any of the salawat, he's not able to make it, at least come to Salatul Jum'ah, attend Salatul Jum'ah with the intention that this will be the cause and the means of me attending the rest of the prayers. If you think about it, attending Salatul Jum'ah is difficult too. Why is it that when we want something, when a person wants something, and he makes an intention for something, then he puts in a little effort. They don't even have to put in that much effort if you really think about it. A person does not need to put in that much effort. He needs to have an intention, a desire to want to do something, then make a slight effort, and then Allah opens up doors from ways they can never imagine. For some people, attending Salatul Jum'ah seems very far-fetched in this part of the world. Sometimes when I sit with our elders that have been here to America for a very long time, attending Salatul Jum'ah was near impossible. Either there was no masjid, or there was no way you would get off of work. There is no way you would be able to take a break from work to attend Salatul Jum'ah. There is no way that high schoolers will be able to pray Salatul Jum'ah. Years ago it seemed far-fetched. But nowadays when an ummah gets together
and tells and demands that we need that Salatul Jum'ah is an obligation, then Allah opens up doors from ways we can never imagine. But if we just sit back, think of it's not a big deal, we don't make the effort, then Allah doesn't help us. Why would Allah want to help those who don't want His help? Make Salatul Jum'ah, come with the intention, attend it with the intention that, Ya Allah, to the barakah of attending Salatul Jum'ah, give me the strength, the tawfiq to attend the rest of the prayers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite this ummah and accept all of our efforts. Jazakumullah.